ask you a question?
Sure, Ben. What do you want to know?
Why are you putting out funny lights around your schools? Why is there a big tree in the square? Why are these people smiling so much? Why are they so happy? And why?
Whoa! Hold your horses, lad. Let me tell you why we are so exceedingly happy. Come over here. Take a seat. Sit down, and I'll tell you a story. A great story. The greatest story ever told. Just like you, every story has a beginning.
The Word was in the beginning, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. God spoke into the void, and the darkness obeyed. It was then the light came and gave life to all the living. In the beginning, in our perfect paradise, man fell. It all could have ended that day, but God gave a promise. Christmas promise. Nazareth, the land of prophets and the law. The place where more than 15 generations of soul had once suffered at the hands of the Lord. Yet hundreds of years before, a prophet named Isaiah had prophesied that one day a Savior would come and set them free. The vision was as such. Mary, a virgin, engaged to a man named Joseph of the house of David, to be blessed. And together, they will bring the Savior into our world.
Greetings, you who are highly favored. The Lord is with you. Do not be afraid, Mary. You have found favor with God. You will conceive and give birth to a son, and you will call him Jesus. He will be great and will be called Son of the Most High. The Lord God will give him the throne of his father David, and he will reign over Jacob's descendants forever. His kingdom will never end.
How can this be, since I am still a virgin?
The Holy Spirit will come on you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. So the Holy One to be born will be called the Son of God. Now indeed, Elizabeth, your relative, has also conceived a son in her old age. And this is now the sixth month for her who was called barren. For with God, nothing will be impossible.
Mary pondered about her encounter with the angel. She was perplexed with what to do, and so doubt began to grow within her.
Give sight to me.
heaven. Let it be to me according to your word.
Joseph was no different, as he felt equally confused. He was a simple carpenter that was honest and faithful, who always did the right thing. Yet, what could he say about his situation?